ISIS has started bulldozing the Asian city of Nimruz.
Militants used military vehicles to destroy at least part of the archaeological site.
Terror group's destruction of an ancient city in Iraq.
This crater is all that remains of the ancient Assyrian city of Nimrud.
It's just unbelievable, the destruction, how they're targeting pre-Islamic cultural heritage. It is part of our human past, and that element, that part of our past, is irretrievably lost. We can do the best that we can to teach our own students about this past, but these students would never be able to visit that palace. That was another reason for choosing this particular model to introduce the students.
Okay. Slide through like that.
The VR is the next best thing.
The course is an introduction to ancient Near Eastern culture. When we get to the Assyrian kings, now we can talk about one of their great cultural expressions, which are these monumental palaces.
They entered a throne room in a palace, and the palace was called the Northwest Palace, and it was built by an Assyrian ruler called Assurbanipal.
So these were meant to be a projection of the might of the empire and the might of the king. They're like mountains, they're so big. And you can't comprehend that human beings created this.
So the way that we're taught with images and little objects, you never understand, you know, what's the scale of these things? What does it feel like to be in the palace? What's the grandeur of such a palace?
Then you're thinking, wouldn't it be ideal if there was a way that we could immerse them in that particular environment? We decided maybe we can start using VR as a possible technology to help build that.
Whoa, oh my god. Whoa, wait, what? I've never done
so
that.
So virtual reality is not really established as a viable instructional tool yet. You know, we're in unknown territory.
What weird, that's so crazy.
It is not about the technology, it is all about how we use the technology to impact education and just help it make a better experience.
Colossal creatures that guard and protect major doorways are often depicted in Assyrian art as having bulls or lions' bodies, wings.
It was a lot more effective as a teaching tool than I had expected. There's a reconstruction of partial of one of these rooms at the Metropolitan Museum of Art. And I take students there as well. But it's nothing like the dizzying sensation of stepping into the throne room in this virtual reality.
It was really amazing to go into VR and get that sense of space.
You have these goosebumps going and you have the chills because the lighting, the sounds, and everything is absolutely like you are in that palace and environment.
The ceiling is so high you have to turn your head to look up at it. It's a physical sensation of stepping into a really large space that is so large it's disorienting.
The highest ceilings, like I don't understand how you paint that high if you're living in, like, I don't even know, 4000 BC.
There's no substitute for the real thing. But what the VR does in combination with the real art is set it into its architectural context in a way that is very difficult for anyone to do with slides.
There are some constants and some almost incomprehensible differences, but understanding the human past and objects that were created in the past, I think it tells us something about what it, you know, the human condition, what it is to be a human.